Hello all, welcome to Selenium with Java October 2021 batch online training session 12. In this session I will try to cover how to read and write data in the Excel sheet through data driven framework, what is keyword driven framework and hybrid driven framework, how we can create the framework keyword and hybrid altogether. So in the last session I already covered how to read the data from the Excel sheet through data driven framework. But today's session, we will learn how to read and write the data with the help of data-driven framework. So data-driven framework, you already seen in the last session, definitely. So one thing is required that we need to require the Eclipse IDE and TestNG, definitely required Selenium jar file required. And we need to also, download the Apache PY jar file. This is the path where you can get all the Apache PY jar file. Once you get all the jar file, you can associate to the project along with the Selenium jar file. In the last session, I already covered it. And definitely Microsoft Excel, through which you can read and write the data, is also required. So Apache PY is an open source library developed and distributed by Apache Software Foundation to design or modify Microsoft Office file using Java program. So in Excel, there are two types of Excel, right? One is the .xls and one is the .xlsx. So if you want to deal with the .xls file, so which we are not using anymore, we are using the .xlsx only, so you can use the XSSF format. Or in case if you want to still use the XLXX, so you can use HSSF format. Okay, so here I already created a project and here the class is already created. So in that particular project I have associated all the jar files. Okay, you could see here the reference file. If you go here, so Selenium jar file, apart from that, all the Apache PY related jar file I already added to the project. So this is the path, you can extract it. So this is the Apache jar file it will look like. So this is the PY jar file. So if you open the project, you need to associate all the jar file available here. Apart from that, some of the jar file will be available in the lib folder, and also some of the jar file will be available in the OOXML-lib folder. So you need to associate all the jar file to the project along with Selenium part. And definitely you need to associate that TestNG, so that TestNG project you can create it. So here I already created a class called Session 12 Read and Write Data. So in that particular class, before creating the class, I'll be creating an Excel sheet, right? So in the D-Dive, I have created Excel sheet. So this Excel sheet name I have given Facebook login credential. So I will try to log into the Facebook page every time. And definitely, in case my credential is getting in it successfully, then I will be writing some data in the Excel. So reading and writing will be possible from the Excel sheet. So this is the Excel I have created, Facebook login credential. And here I have created three columns. One is the user ID column, one is the password column, one is the test result column. So user ID, definitely I want to pass username and password 1, 2, 3 like that. And definitely each and every time I want to update the result in case it is getting passed, right? So you, in the Excel sheet, you already finding three different sheets, sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3. So how you can read the data from the Excel sheet? So for that, first you need to navigate to the path of the Excel sheet where it is kept. Then you need to get the Excel sheet name. Then you need to get the workbook name. Then you need to go to the row number. And then you can go to the cell, right? So whenever you'll be reading and writing the data, so you can directly convert the cell to the string, so that any value it will consider as a string only. So that is the important thing you need to remember. First you'll go to the path, you'll go to the Excel sheet name, then once Excel sheet is open, you will go to the workbook, right? This is the workbook, then row number, and then cell or the column corresponding value. So that's why I can read the data from the Excel sheet. Similar fashion, I can write the data in the Excel sheet. So here I'll be creating the project. This is the project, session 12 read write data. So I am declaring some global variable, which is web driver driver, XSF workbook, the variable name is workbook, XSF sheet and XSF cell. So first I'll go to the workbook, then sheet and then cell, right? So I'm declaring the global variable so that I can read and I can use any point of time in that class itself. I'm creating two before test and after test. You already seen in the test ng. In case you are using that before test, after test, you no need to write the similar sort of step, right? So as and when any number of tests will occur, right, it will go in the before test or after test, or before method, after method, you can call it, whatever is required, so that every time it will log in and be successful. From the before test, I'm creating a setup method where I am setting the properties for the Chrome driver, I'm creating a object for the Chrome driver, I'm maximizing the driver, that's all I'm doing. And after test, I'm quitting the driver every time. Whatever, whenever test will be called, I'll be quitting the driver. And in the add the rate introduction, that will be considered test cases, where I'll be creating a method called Facebook login page. So here first I'm creating the, I'm launching the Facebook page, driver.get Facebook page. Then you already seen, right, how to read the data with the help of file class. So first it will be file class. So I'll be creating the object of interest for the file class, where I am passing the reference for the, that particular Excel sheet. In the D drive, I have kept it. The Facebook login credential is the seed name, and .xls is the extension. So after that, I want to load the file. So I'll be creating an object creation for the file input stream class, where I am providing the reference for the file class. Then once the load the file is successful, definitely I'll be going to the workbook directly. So for all the thing, I have created the global variable, right? Here you could see here. Workbook, worksheet, and cell. That is the reason directly I can call them. So I'll be creating a that variable, calling it for the new workbook, where I am providing the reference to the file input stream. Then once workbook is there, right, I need to go to the worksheet, right? So where the worksheet is present, so I can either go with the seed name or indexing. So it is a zeroth index, so definitely I can get the worksheet with the zeroth index. Then in the worksheet, I want to read how many active row is there, right? So I will go to the worksheet and I will go to the get last row number. So that's why I can get the total number of rows available. This is the row 1, row 2, row 3, row 4, like that. It will be row 0, row 1, row 2, row 3. So total number is 4. Right? So once I get how many rows data is available, I will try to read the data with the help of for loop. You can see here I am starting with I equal to 1. Why I am starting with I equal to 1? Because this is the header. So definitely I don't want to read that. So I am starting with i equal to 1 till that equal to total number of thing. So it is starting with I equal to 1 and total number of row is 4. It is going to the 4 less than equal to I plus plus. Then whenever I am iterating for the I loop, right, I am going to the cell. So definitely once I go to the worksheet, I can go to the row and then cell. You can see this is the cell, right? So for every cell, I'll be going to the worksheet again and get up every I and get cell, because this is my zeroth cell. So that is the zeroth cell. I am reading the user ID. Okay. I am converting to string type, and here for the Facebook page, right? This is the Facebook page. So you could see this is the email ID. ID equal to email if you want to inspect it. So this is the email ID. I'll be converting to a web element. Similarly, for the password, it will be password. So here I am identifying the web element with the help of email ID. Every time I'm clearing the field, and after that time, every time I'm entering the field from that Excel, right? Similar way for the password field also, every time I will do the same thing, where cell number will be 1 because that is the password field, cell number 1. It is the cell number 0, right? Every time for every I am entering the password field also. Then here, after that, whenever I am clearing, I will be wait for 2 seconds every time. Then I want to write the data as well, right? So you know that file output stream is the class through which I can write the data in the Excel sheet. So I am creating an object for instance for the file output stream, where I am taking the reference to the file, same file. Right, then whatever result you want to update it, right, working fine or path, you can update, you can store in some REST thing. Then I am navigating to the worksheet. For every I am creating a new cell, and where I am setting the value, whatever I want to pass it, and then after that I want to write the data. So that is the lines of code I have written here. So now you could see test result is blank. Let's close the file and let's run the codes and see how the reading of data is possible and how your result is getting also updated. So definitely, that before running the test case, it will try to do the setup method, call the setup method where it will try to set up the properties for the browser, it will maximize the browser. After that, it will go to the test case where it will launch the page, Facebook, it will identify the user ID email field, it will enter the value, again it will clear the value, again for the third iteration it will clear the value, enter the value, and it will quit the browser. So this time number of run will be 3, right, for the same data set, and you can see Facebook login page is getting successful. Now if you open the Excel sheet, you could see here the output data also should get updated accordingly. Initially it was blank, but now it should update it every time. Okay, you could see here for 3 iteration data is getting updated. Now if you again remove it, right, and if you want to change the data here, output data from the code, right, instead of pass you can mention working fine. And if you run it, so for 3 iterations it will run, even if you want to change the iteration, so 5 iterations it will run, and every time it will update the result as well. So reading and writing is happening at the same time with the help of Apache PUI, right? So 5 things required: Eclipse is required, Excel is required, Selenium jar file is required, test engine is required, and the Apache PUI is required. So every time it will clear the value and it will update the result in the Excel sheet. Okay, you can see here this case is got passed. Now if you open the Excel sheet, you can see the time is 1990, right? It means 7:19 p.m. If you open it, now it will be updated with the data called working as expected, working fine, right, whatever you want to write it. Now if you want to run for two combination, two set of data, you can just add it, remove it. If you want to write for four combination, you can just change it. So the automatically every combination test result will also get updated, right? Now if you want to run for four combination or five combination, right, it will, you can simply change it, and test result you can make it remove, I mean blank, so that it will update it based on the run. So same way data reading or writing will happen from the Excel sheet. First you need to identify the path of the Excel sheet and what is the extension, what is the name, right? Then in case it is a 2007 format onward, you can use XSSF. In case it is .xlsx, you can use HSSF. So once you already know the path, right, so you can go to the workbook. So it will be seat 1, seat 2, seat 3. If you want to go to the seat name, you can go it, either you can go with the index. Then if you go to the workbook, you can go to the worksheet, right? Sorry, for past you will go to the worksheet, then workbook, then you will go to the row, right? And then you will read how many row is available. Then how many row is available, you can create a for loop, right? So for loop can start from 0 or the 1, because the first row is the header. So I will start from the row number 1 and till the maximum number of row. And then column wise, I know that for the first column, column 0 or the first column, it is the user field. For the second column, it is the name field. And for the third column, I want to create a new cell where I want to write the data. So that's way you can go to the first workbook, then worksheet, then row, and then cell. And definitely for every row, how many maximum number of record is there, you can start from the 1 and it will go to the maximum 1, and every row iteration you can use a for loop, and that is the reason every time you can read the data, and for every reading the data you can write the data with the help of file output stream. Right here, whatever test result you want to update it, you can change it so that everywhere it will be updated accordingly. Now it's, you could see this run for 5 times. Now if you go to that D drive, right, that particular Excel sheet, you can see here the test result will also get updated accordingly for that number of iteration, right? You can see this is changed for 6 times because I want to iterate for the 6 times. Now if you want to iterate for 2 times only, right, and you can remove it, now you can save it and you can run it for 2 times. So that is the easiest way. Everything will be derived from the Excel sheet, right? Whatever number of combination, number of times you want to iterate it, it will be driven by the data sheet, not the code. So that is the reason it is called the data-driven testing. So it will be driven by the data set. So in case you want to automate the number of iteration, you no need to touch your code. You will be only just updating the data set. So based on the data set setting, automatically your number of run will be successful, and definitely every time it will give you the correct result in the new column. So that's why we can read and write the data with the help of Apache PY. So now you open the Excel sheet, you could see here, right? So number of iteration will be 2, and every time it's the result got updated. Okay, so that's why you can read and write the data. So definitely you need to download, go to that particular path, and you need to download all the Apache PY data jar file. You need to associate in the Eclipse new project, and different test engine Selenium jar file will be associated, and the Microsoft Excel, you need to create some column where you can pass the information based on the your requirement, right? In case if you want to pass user ID, password, or other thing, you can also create multiple cells value, and based on the number of iteration, you can pass it. But the approach will be still same, right? First, you can go to the file, create an object instance for the file, where you can go to the path of that part. Then you can, with the help of file input stream, you can load the data. Then you can go to the workbook. Then you can go to the worksheet, where definitely you can either provide the seat number or seat index. Then you can get the active row count, how many rows is available. Once you get the active row, you can go to the, you can extrude that first column, first row, where you are giving the heading. You can start from the second row, you can go to the next row. And after that, you can go to the directly cell. And with the reference of that, you can directly add the value. So similar way, in case if you want to enter for 3 or 4 cells, you can use that, create that variable. And if you want to write that data, so you can use the file output stream class, right? And definitely you can create a new cell where you want to update the data, and you can update it with the help of file output stream class in the workbook and worksheet. Any questions? So I'll give you the code, definitely you can try, no need to worry.
Just one question that I just want to ask you. So nowadays mostly we are using Google Sheet instead of Excel Sheet. So is it possible for you to include that, how to read and write from the Google Sheet?
Which sheet, sorry?
Google Sheet, Google. Google.
Google Sheet. No, I did not work as of now. I will see
what
in case. Yeah, tell me.
Yes, what is it? Most of the companies are moving from Microsoft to Google Docs, Switch, and they are now using Google Sheets.
Okay.
Instead of Excel.
Mm-hmm.
My company as well, they moved from Excel to Google Sheet, and I have to gradually, once they retire using Microsoft, I have to convert that.
Yeah, I will see, and in case I am able to create some video, I'll definitely try to do it. Yeah, no problem. Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah, sure. So this is the code, you can use it. So I have written it for my customers. What then? So this is all about the data-driven framework. So you are reading the writing the data from the data sheet only, which can be external source. It is not the Excel sheet. It can be CSV file, it can be a database, and you are mentioning the Google Sheet, it can be. So just you need to just some sort of modification only, but otherwise I don't think that your approach will change much. But yeah, we need to customize our code a little bit maybe. So another two framework we are considering, we are discussing, right, which is the keyword driven framework, and another the hybrid framework. So hybrid framework is nothing but the combination of data driven and the keyword driven only. But keyword driven, so here we are working with the data from the data driven framework. But keyword-driven framework, we will run everything from the keyword, okay? So keyword-driven framework is a technique in which all the operation or the instruction to be performed are written separately from the actual test case. The similarity it has with data-driven framework is that the operation to be performed is again stored in an external file, right, like Excel sheet or a CSV file or the database. User can easily control and specify the functionality that they want to use. So that is the simple structure here. So This is your keyword library, where you will be storing in some Excel sheet. The library means, suppose whatever operation you want to perform, like set, click, navigate, you can store them. And whatever, and after that you can create your automation script, which will be interacting with the AOT or application under stress, where you can read or write the data both ways. So that's how your keyword-driven framework will work. So what are the different advantages of the keyword-driven framework? So single keyword can be used across multiple test scripts, so the code will be reusable. So we'll be creating the keyword only one time, suppose click. So definitely in case there is a link, hyperlink, button, we can use the click operation. If you want to set something, right? So that in case it is a text box, right, we can set some value, right? Suppose say in case if you want to click, suppose it is a radio button checkbox, you can also click it. So that, I mean, with the same thing, we'll be creating one time, but we can use them multiple times. If you want to create some verification point, right, for the code, some for verifying something, and in case we'll be using multiple times, we can use the same code. So that is the reason to be writing once, but we'll be using multiple times. User can write the detailed test plan having desired input and verification data in the form of simple and convenient spreadsheet. Okay. In case some expert having expertise of scripting language used by the automation tool can create utility script well before the creation of the detailed test plan, then the testing engineer is able to use the automation tool immediately through the spreadsheet input method, and for this they need not master the constant scripting language used by the automation tool. So definitely whenever you will be using any framework, it will be like effort will be reduced, right? And whatever effort you will be spending, right, it will be very, very more productive, right? So initial definitely time, some sort of knowledge will be required, and some sort of transition will be required, but once you are habituated, so with minimal intervention, right, with minimal effort, you can able to create the framework. So that is the basic advantage. So definitely disadvantage I was discussing, right? So initial time you need to spend lot of additional effort, you need to go some certification, go for some training, you need to get some support from the additional external support, right? And definitely, right, it is the framework part, so you need to learn some sort of knowledge or technology, all this stuff, you need to do it. Otherwise, it will not be easy, right? So this is the basic disadvantage of the keyword-driven framework. So if you want to differentiate between the data and keyword-driven framework, so most of the interviewer can ask the question. So definitely, the main difference is that data-driven framework cannot be started until your code or application is working fine. But the keyword-driven framework, you can start before your application is up and running. So as and when you are getting the requirement, you can start developing your framework. You don't need to worry about your application completeness, right? Similarly, for the keyword-driven framework, planning has to be extensive and precise for keyword-driven framework. Whereas planning is easy since it is only needed for the test data and the test script. So data-driven framework comparatively harder to maintain since the abstraction is only between the test data and script. Whereas keyword-driven framework is easy to maintain due to more abstraction layer between test script, test data and keyword. I'll show you one by one. Then the next one is the hybrid framework. The hybrid framework in Selenium is a concept where tester will be using the advantage for the both data-driven and the keyword-driven. So it's a combination, we'll be using the keyword concept as well as we'll try to read the data for the different data script, right, data set. So it is an easy to use framework which allows manual tester to create test cases by just looking at the keyword, test data and object repository without coding into the framework much. Okay, so in this framework, the keyword as well as the test data are externalized. So not only your keyword, so your keyword will be stored in some external data source and your kind of element properties will be stored in some sort of properties file. So you can separate them. Okay. So keywords are maintained in a separate Java class file and test data will be maintained either in a properties file or Excel file and can use the data provider of a test engine framework. What are the different advantages of the hybrid framework is having?
So where we can store the keywords, you told, in Excel sheet again?
Yeah, so keyword will be stored in Excel sheet. Yeah, but the properties you can store in some sort of Excel sheet as well as the data provider sheet called maybe properties file. I'll be showing you, no need to worry, okay. So this is the part I'll be showing in, and after the today's session is over, next two sessions I'll be creating a framework from the scratch. okay, where I will be using the page object model concept, and definitely the Apache PY concept, and then we'll be creating instead of calling the driver from that some desktop, right, we'll be placing the in the same framework, and we'll be using the report ng and extend report. All this stuff will be in the next 2 sessions you will be getting to know. But this is the different concept of the framework. So where we'll be creating the framework with the help of page object model design pattern. So this is a 4 framework. One is the linear framework, nowadays we are not using. One is the data-driven framework, one is the keyword framework, and one is the hybrid framework, which is a combination of data and the keyword. But your page object model or page vector model is the design pattern, which will be helping you to organize your framework in a structured way. Please be remembered. Okay. Anyway, whenever I'll be covering the POM or page object model, you can get to know details here. So these are the different advantage of the hybrid framework is having maintainability, right? Because you can maintain it easily, because we are keeping our kind of keyword and the data different way, right? So I mean data means properties, so that maintainability is easy. Reusability will be easy, right? You will be creating the library functions for one and you will be using them. Accessibility, it's easy to design, develop, modify, debug test cases wherever executing, right? Flexibility. So it is independent because we are keeping in some different other way, right? One is in the properties file, one is the in the other Excel sheet. So definitely, I mean, we can easily segregate the data and we can use them as and when required. We can figure, I mean, in case some error is coming, we can easily isolate them and we can debug them. So let's go to the framework here. I have created the keyword dependent framework and hybrid framework altogether. So this is the project I have created. Okay, so let's first try to understand how we have designed that particular project. So this is the project. So you can create a normal project. So after the normal project is created, so you can associate your jar file, right? So this is the same way. You need to associate your Selenium jar file and the all the Apache PY jar file. So this is the only jar file you need to associate it. So that is the second part. So first you need to create a project, you need to associate all the jar file, then you will be creating a object.properties file. So how can you create a file here? So if you right click the project, click on the new, and you can see here there is a option called file. If you click on the file, and here you can give the file name, right? So object.properties, if that file extension should be properties, and name you can give anything. So that is the file. Next step you need to create it. So this is the file I have created, where you can keep all the information for the different properties, URL, implicit type, explicit type, whatever is required. So here I have tried to create the simple one. That is the reason I did not written much. So in the framework, whenever I'll be creating from scratch, you can get to know whatever is really required, you can just try to add them. So suppose say I'll be automating that one ready home page, right? I'll be creating two test cases, say two or three, whatever you require, you can create some test case. So one test case, I will be entering some username and password, and I will click on the sign in button. So that will be one test case. Other test case, I will be entering my email and password field and clicking on the forgot password. And then whatever test case you want to automate, you can do it. Just I am just given some simple example. One test case, I will be entering username password and click on the sign in button. Other test case, I will be entering username password field and clicking on the forgot password. So that is my two test case. If you want to go to the other test case, you can do it. No need to worry. So this is simple test case I will be using. Okay. So here my URL will be that one. Right, that is the URL I have copied and pasted it here. Then whenever I'll be interacting, right, so I need to identify the username field, I need to identify the password field, I need to inspect that sign in button, and I need to click on the forgot password link as well. So these are the four fields I have tried to add it: username, password, sign in button, and the forgot password. And for these four fields, right, I have identified some of the properties. Element locator technique, with the help of element locator technique here. So for the username field, I have given, one second, yeah, I have given login value. So it is the ID, right? So I will show you how I will be identifying with the help of ID. Similarly, because I will require unique one, right? For the password field, I have given password, PASSWD, which is the name one. So I will be showing you the different web element locator technique. I can identify the one, identify the different element. Then for the sign in field, right, you can see the name I have given proceed. This is the proceed name I have given. And the, for the forgotten password link, definitely I can identify with the help of link text. So this is the, my forgot password link. So that is the first part. So we'll create the project first. We'll associate all the jar file, including the Apache PO or the Selenium jar file. Next one, we'll be creating a properties file from the project. Then the next one is the I can create a test cases file. Testcase.xlx file, this is the file name. And here I can create the test cases based on my keyword. So how can you get it? So I already created the project. So sometime it might be difficult to open the Excel from here. One thing is that you can go to the properties so that you can get the path of the project. And you can search in the project with the help of Windows R button, and you can go to directly that project. You can definitely get to know what are the object file, what are the SRC folder is created, right? And you can open the test case sheet from here. So this is the Excel created, testcase.xlsx. So everything will be XSF format, not the XSF. So this is the two test cases I have created. So first one, row, I am creating the header. What is the header? Test case name one is the header, keyword is the header, object is the header, object type is the header, then the value is the header. Test case is the objective of the test case, right? You already, in case you are already working for multiple years in the functional testing, you can know. So this is the simple formula. You can change it as and when required, no need to worry. This is my test case. Log in to the Rediff page with inbuilt credential. The keyword. First, I will be navigating to the URL. I am writing based on my need. I am not following anything. Just I am typing. See, already I am given the name as called navigatory URL because first time I load the URL. And value I have given is URL. So you can change it. No need to worry. It is not hard and fast that it is fixed component. No, you can change it. Then I am creating a keyword called set text, where I can set the value, right? So object is my username. So this is my username. This is my username, object. And this is my value. So I am giving corresponding object type as ID, right? So because for the first one, I have given the ID equal to that login. So if you want to give some other value, you can change the object type. And this is my value will be I want to give it. Similarly, for the password field, because it will be also input field, I can also use the same thing, same set text. For the password field, I have given that past, PASSW, which is nothing but the name, right? And this is the password I want to enter it. Then I want to click on the sign in button. So I will be performing the operation called click, because I can button, link, hyperlink, you need to click on the link, right? And this is the sign in button, this is the variable here, right? And this is the name proceed. So I have tried to map with name. So that's how you can try to map it. So if you go to the Rediff page again, I am showing you. So this is the user ID field, username field. So I am creating a variable called username. And here ID equal to login. I have given here login. Right? And here I am mapping with the ID because it is matching with ID. So in case if you want to change the XPath, you can give the XPath here. And you can mention the instead of ID, you can mention XPath. Similarly, for the second field, I have given password, right? PASSWD, which is matching with name. Suppose if you want to change with ID equal to password, you can give here password and you can change with ID instead of name. So that is the simple thing you can change it. So there is no hard and fast rule. You can change the variable name as well. So here it should be matched, right? With match with here. So username should be matched here. And you are identifying with the help of ID, so that ID here need to be matched. Password field need to be matched here. And here you are identifying with the help of name, it should be matched, name field should be matched here. Sign in button field should be matched here. And here you will can identify with the name of name, so that it should be matched. Similarly, forgot password, right? So I'll be, you can see here, I will be, object type will be link text, right? So I have given it link. So I will be clicking on that. Otherwise, again, navigate to same URL, text, set text, text password. This is the two test cases I want to execute.
Here, then?
Yes.
Yeah, that's a quick question. So, looking at sheet for keyboard reader, so the first thing keyword, what is the keyword column indicate here?
Keyword means the keyword, right? You want to operate something, the operation that is called keyword.
So is it used anywhere in the?
No, I'll be showing you. This is the simple thing I've written based on the thing. So if you want to check with only set, you can change it to set. Okay.
Okay, this is just like
a because I'll be entering some value, so I have mentioned the set text. I want to click, so I have mentioned in set click. Suppose say instead of navigate to URL, you can mention that launch URL, right? Based on your thing, based on your project need or organization need, you can mention it. Just I have simple thing I have written it here. Navigate to URL.
Yeah, no,
okay.
Yeah,
suppose you can change it to
column,
yeah. Yes, tell me.
The second column object is basically the
variable, right? Whatever you are mentioning in that particular object or properties file, this is the variable. So that should be exactly matched. Anything, right? It can be anything.
Anything, right?
For most of the project, they used to mention that variable as well as the type. So you can mention username text field, right? So you can easily understand. Password text field, sign in button, that is the reason, right? Forgot password link, I can mention it, variable name. And this is the object type, means the element locator.
But the object type is the actual identifier
which
have to use
yes
from the page
right from the page. Here the corresponding value you need to mention here.
And one question I want to ask you, so we are passing some values after the object type.
Yes, right, this is the value.
Is it possible with the keyword driven that we can pass dynamic values or
this is the dynamic value, right? This is the dynamic value. You can change it any time from the Excel sheet.
No, this is dynamic value before the run. But once
yes.
the run is going on,
you
cannot change it, right?
Yes.
You have to predefine in the
So you can use some formula, okay, it not be a problem. Okay, you can if you want to change, you can do some dynamic value as well, right? But in the real time, every time we used to update our data sheet, right? Before running it. Suppose say if you want to create, right, if you go for the second data combination, so you'll be updating the data sheet first, right, before running it. So that is the your value. So you need to update only one time. The value you need to update one time. Otherwise, before running it, you can update your value.
So I'm saying before running the test, you need to correctly prepare the sheet.
Right, because that is the every automation tester need to do, right? Otherwise, how it will work? That is called test data sheet preparation. Right?
No, I got it, but what I'm saying,
some of the thing you can definitely you can use some formula so that automatically it will be incremented by one like that, all this stuff. Okay. So that is the second part, Excel preparation. The next one is that, so whatever object we are writing here, right, we are identifying here, we need to read it, right? So in the SRC file, we'll be creating some packages. One is the call operation. So in same package also you can do it. And this is the different package I have created for easy identification. In one package also you can keep everything. But test case package, well, I'll be creating the test cases. Operations, I'll be creating some reusable component for the operation. And this is the Excel import and file IO for reading and writing data from the Excel sheet. So I have created a Java class, which is the read properties file. So first I want to read the file. So this is the first class I have created. So this is my properties class, read properties file class. So you already know, if you do not know, that there is a properties class available through which you can read the properties from the object.properties file. So I'll be creating an object.instance for the properties class with the help of properties class. If you click the export, right, you can see the properties is the property class. It is coming from the properties class packages. Then I'll be creating a method of the properties class, which will be public in nature and get object repository, where with the help of input stream, I can read the data. So here the properties file is stored in my same project, right? So with the help of system.getproperties.user.directory, I can get the direct part of the project. After that, I am concatenating with object.properties. That's why with the help of input stream, I can read the data from the properties file. Then I'll be loading the data, all the data from that with the help of input stream, and I'll be turning it. So that's the lines of code you need to write it for reading the data from the properties file, and I'm returning it. So reading is done. So you need to create a first class for reading the properties file. So here you'll be calling the properties class, creating an object code instance. Then you'll be creating a method. Method return type will be properties and public in nature, right? Then with the help of input stream method, you can create a object for reading the data for the properties file. Then how can you read the data? Definitely you can give the complete path of the files, but this is the through that only system.getPropertyUser.directory, you can directly go to the project. So after that, I am concatenating the properties file so that I can read it. After that, I'll be loading all the data and returning P. So P is nothing but the properties file, right? Object. So that is the return type is also properties. So that is the next step. Second, next one is that you need to create a class for the keyword operation. So whatever operation we are doing, right? So in the Excel sheet, whatever operation we are doing, right? So we'll be trying to match everything, right? So you can see here, we'll be declaring some variable, global variable called webDriverDiver. We are creating a constructor. You know, this is the constructor name, it is same name as the class name. And where I am passing the webDriver reference, and this dot diver equal to diver, so that diver and that diver will be matched. So that is the one line of code you will write it whenever you are constructor. Otherwise, the driver will change every time and your code will not work successfully. Yeah, so I already covered in Java that this part, right, this operator. So this operator is nothing. Suppose say in case if you do not use the this operator, right? So if you use driver equal to driver, it will create problem. So that driver equal to that driver, it will not match. Okay, it will consider only that driver two times, driver equal to driver, and here that driver will not match. Though it is the same variable, but your value will not be associated. So you can use driver equal to driver, right? Every time you can see the reference is showing that driver only. But that driver and that driver is not matching. So I need to match both the driver. So that is the reason I should use this dot driver equal to driver, so that this dot driver will signify that driver and that driver will signify that driver. So that is the usage of this operator. Okay. So in case you are defining something globally and you are creating a constructor, okay, so you can use this operator. So that this dot driver you can consider and assign with the local driver whatever you are passing in the constructor. Then I'll be creating a method called perform, where I am providing different variable. What is the properties file? I am taking it from here, properties, and the variable is P. Then other variable I'll be creating called operation. So which is I am taking from the Excel. Right, the operation, then the object name, keyword is here operation, object name, this is the object. So it should not be the same thing, just kind of, because it is a variable, right? So variable should not be matched with the same thing, no need to worry. Then object type, which is that same type of the object, and then the value. This is the five different variable I am passing through that particular method. And here I'll be creating a switch statement. So whenever I was talking covering the Java, so in the real-time framework, that switch will be required to give or to create the method for operation. So here, first one I'm using as a click, right? So here it should be matched with that one, click. And it should be alphabetical order. So if you want to check click one, so here also need to be click one. So every time I am doing some operation called to uppercase, so that in any case whatever we have written, it should be changed to uppercase, right? Uppercase, lowercase, that doesn't matter. So that is the reason I am converting it to uppercase. So what is the objective of the click? So it will try to click something, right? So it will perform the operation called click. and how it will perform the operation. So driver dot find element will get, from where that element it will get this driver, right, this, and then the get object. From where get object is coming, so this will come. So before that we need to create another object. Okay, this is the get object. Okay, let's try to explain this one. After that I will, or maybe before creating that one, you can create a another one method called get object, where you can give the properties file reference as well as the object name and object type. Here you will be using the if loop. So object type, in case it is equal to XPath, so whatever element located is available, I will try to match with everything. You know, ID, name, CSS selector, XPath, link text, partial link text, and tag name. You can give all the reference here, and you can get the object, get object method. So it will giving till the by. So means driver dot find element by dot XPath, the XPath value. So that's what I am trying to match it here. This is the object type. It is coming from the object type, right? And it is equal, ignore case, it is equal to XPath, right? So that is the simple thing I will try to copy from here. So ID, name, it should be matched with here. In case it is XPath, so it will give you by dot XPath, and it, that is the XPath name. You need to give it. So similarly, in case it is a class name, you can check with class name. In case it is a name, you can give it. In case it is ID, in case it is CSS, in case it is a link, it can be a partial link. So you can check with all this stuff. After that, once the get object is created, then you can create that one for switching, for creating the context of each and every operation or method, right? So this is called keyword or operation. So here I will be creating the perform method through which I can perform. So through the click, what I'll do, I'll go to the driver dot find element, and this dot object get object, I will get it, right? What it will return? It will return me by dot element locator and the corresponding value. So that it is returning. And what is the operation? Operation is click, because I want to click here. Similarly, for set text, what is the operation? I can send values, right? Send keys. Similarly, in case it is a navigate URL, so I can directly enter the value. So that's why if you want to create multiples, if you want to create multiples operation, you can do it, right? If you want to verify something, if you want to set attributes, so that's why you can create some keyword. So that particular keyword should match with here only. So that is the simple thing you need to remember. So here, as we are ignoring case, so that is the reason we can give it caps or small word. Otherwise, you can match with without ignoring. If you want to match, you can match with same way. So that's why I am matching with that one. This is the two important method I need to create. One is the perform method, where I will try to use all my keyword, which is the nothing but the operation, where I'll be using some switch statement. And if I want to inspect the element with the help of different element locator technique, I'll be using the if else ladder statement. In case it is matching with that one, it will identify the XPath. In case it is not matching with ID, it will identify with ID, name, CSS selector, link text, partial link text, tag name, whatever the element locator technique, you need to give all the details. So that is done. So here I will be creating two methods. One is for performing the operation of the with the help of keyword. Another will be, it will be matched with the object type. An object I am getting with the help of property class, whatever I have already created, read properties file. So this is the three part I already done. And then the next one, value, definitely, if you want to pass some value, right, you can get it directly from here. Because if you want to send keys, so value will be displayed, right, you need to enter some value. So this is the value. If you want to launch the URL, it will be also value, right? So that is the reason you need to give the same value, variable value. Here also you need to change, you don't need to change it. In case you are changing, so that also should need to be changed accordingly. So now my fourth column has been linked here. Then the next one is, in the other packages, I'll be creating an class for reading the Excel file. Right? So here you can see I have created a read Excels method where I will provide the reference called file path. So you already know I need to go to the file path, then file name, and then the seed name. Right? So I'll be creating a object.instance for the file class where I'm giving the file path plus file name. So that's why I'm directly interacting with the file path. Then with the help of file input stream, right, I am reading the workbook, and here I am giving some condition. In case workbook is matching with XLSF, right, I'll be using XSSF. In case it is matching with XLS, I'll be work with HSS. So that is a simple thing. If you do not want to do it, you can ignore it simply, because otherwise you will be taking the default XSSF. Then I am going to the seat and I am returning the seat. So that is the part I am creating an Java class. So where I am still going to the file path, file name, and the seed name. So this is the prerequisite. You need to first write it before creating any test cases. Now here I have created multiple test cases. So first one test case is, this is for the keyword driven testing or keyword driven framework. So this is the test case I have written. So here you can see this is my test cases. I am defining some variable for the global web driver is equal to web driver. I am not matching with the driver because I have already created here the driver one, right? And here I am creating the before test and after test. So before test is nothing but setting up the properties for the Chrome driver, maximize the driver, right? And after test, every time I'll be quitting the driver. So how many test cases I am having? I am having two test cases. So here, this is my test cases. So whenever I want to go to the test cases, right? So I have to first create some object or instance for whatever class we have created, right? So this is the class I have created. So I have created an object here. This is the another class I have created, read, right, read properties file. So I have created object, and then for the properties class, I will be creating another object where I will be calling that method, right. This is my method from the properties class, get object repository. So here I have created another object where I am just directly navigating to the properties class and I am calling that method. Then for the keyword operation class, I am creating object. So that is the simple thing. It is called object and class. For every class, you need to create an object first. Otherwise, how you will interact with the class? So simple thing we are doing only. So for three class, I have created three objects, which is relevant here. This is the one class in the package. This is the one class. This is the one class. So I have created first three objects. This is the one object. This is the one object. This is the one object. Other object I have created to go to that method directly, whatever available for reading the properties file. Then in the Excel class, right, still I am reading the file, file name, file path, and the seed name. Then here, from here, I will start running the seed. So here I am providing the, you can see here, this is the path I am giving for the Excel, this is the Excel name, and this is the seed tag, seed name. This is my seed name. So that's why I am directly reading the seed. Right? After reading the seed, I already going to the seed with the help of test seed variable from the seed class. Then I am identifying how many active row is there. Right? So it is the last row minus the first row plus one. Why I am giving the plus one here? Because last row minus first row, it will give you, suppose say it is 0th row and it is 9th row. So it will give you 9 minus 0 equal to 9, right? But here original 10 column is there, sorry, 10 row is there, because starting from 0th, that is the reason I am incrementing plus 1. So to get the total number of row, right? Because in Java, in everything is starting from 0, right? So in case it is a 9, it will give you 9 minus 0 equal to 9. But actually, 0 is also a row, right? So it is considering 10 row. So if you give the last row minus the first row, you need to add 1 to get the total number of row, active row. So similarly, that formula I have used. Now I will use a simple for loop. So it will start from the 1, because first row I am having that only header. So I want to discard them. Then I will go to the row where how I can get the row equal to sit test sit dot get row. For each and every I will get the row. Now I am giving some condition. So what is the condition? Please follow carefully. So here I have written my test cases. Okay, you could see here, this is my test cases. So whenever there is a test cases, there is no keyword I have given. So that's why I will try to identify the Excel, right? And here there is my keyword, but there is no step associated, no test case associated. Similarly for the second test case, so that's why I can identify. In case some value is present in my first column, so that will be test cases, right? And in case value is available from second column onward, right, second column, so that will be my operation for the particular test case. So that's why I will identify the test case and the action or the keyword. So forget about the first column, first row. From the second row wise, whenever there is a data available in the first column, so that will be considered as my test case, because in the other column corresponding to that row, there is no value associated. But in case my first column is blank, definitely there is some actions or keyword available. Similar way, for the second test case, corresponding column, there is no value, so that will be my test case. But for the other column, whenever there is no test case reference available, that will be my actions or keyword. So that's why I will try to implement in the code, right? So I am giving a if loop. If row dot get cell 0 to string dot length equal to 0, means there is no equal to 0, means that one, the test case column will be blank, then I will perform the operation. So I am trying to perform the operation. So I is print out cell 1 to cell 4, right? I am trying to perform the operation with the help of that method, right? What I will do, I will perform the operation and I will print it out accordingly. In case it is containing the value not equal to equal to null, then I will concatenate with that what, new test case, and it will print it out with the cell value. So that value I will be printing it out. So here I am again reiterating it. So definitely I have created the object or instance for each and every classes, whatever you have created, three classes created. That is one class, that is two class, that is three class, I have created the object. And for that keyword properties file, sorry, read properties file, I have created another object with the help of that object reference. Now I will be going to the seed directly. So definitely if you want to go to the seed directly, I can call the method, right, called get prop, called read Excel, where I can give the path of the path Excel name as well as the seed name, right? Then I can read the how many row is available, because it is starting from 0, so it will give me last row minus first row plus 1. Then I will be iterating for the for loop, where I will be starting with 1, because I want to discard the first one, which is the heading part. Then for every row I want to give a if condition. In case my first column value is blank only, then I will perform the operation, and those operations will be printed out in my console. And in case it is a not null, then I will be concatenating with new test case name along with the value, means test case name. So that is the part I will be doing in my test case, and that is the called keyword driven approach with the help of keyword. Let's try to run the code and let's see how your code is behaving and how your object output is coming in. We need to close the Excel, otherwise it might be problem. So definitely every time, please remember that you are closing your Excel. So it is logging into the ready page. It will enter the email password and click on the sign in button. So that is my first test case. So it's waiting because the page is fully not loaded. Okay. Second test case, it will enter the user ID and password field. It will click on the forgot password. So that will be my second test case. Okay, so both my test cases working perfectly fine. Now if you go to the console, you can see here. So total number of run equal to 1, failure equal to 0, test case is passed at us. Now if you go to the console, you can see here. So how test case is executed, right? So this is the new test case. Because in case it is matching with that one, it is starting with login to ready mail with invalid credential. So test execution started, right? I have added it. That now navigation to the URL, those are the steps happening. The URL I am passing, then set text, username field, I am identifying with the help of ID and I am entering the value. Again, set text, password, with the help of name, element locator technique, I am entering the value called password 1234 and I am clicking on the sign in button with the help of name properties. Another test case I am executing, which is again new test case. Click on the forgotten password link in Rediff mail page test, which is started. So navigating to the URL, setting the password, username and password, and clicking on the forgotten password link. So my test case is got passed. Any questions? So definitely it is not an easy one. So definitely framework will be complicated. So you need to go through multiple times to understand the framework. But it is, in simple way, I have tried to rewrite it, all the code. If you do some mistake, it will be might be trouble for you, right? Because the framework in the real time also it not been easy. If you do single mistake to fix it, it will might be harder, right? So that is the reason, right? You need to just create some component by component. So I'll be showing you in the next two sessions how we'll be creating the framework from the component by component. And definitely if I want to cover everything in a single frame, it will take me huge time. But definitely that is the reason I am trying to cover all the possible area. So after that you can build your framework, your customized part by your own self. Okay. Because framework is the complicated one. But until you are not knowing all the concept, it will not be easy for you to build the framework from the scratch. But definitely. So all the modular part will be showing and how what is the approach will be covered in my upcoming session as well. So after that you can build your part by doing some R&D. So that is the keyword part already covered, keyword driven part. The next test case I have covered it for the hybrid framework. So remaining part will be not be changing for the hybrid framework as well. But the some concept you need to change for the hybrid, because in the hybrid framework will be reading, right, will be using the keyword and data driven approach. So what is the data driven approach? So whenever you will be using the data driven approach, right, will be using some sort of data provider. So that is the same concept I have used it in the hybrid framework as well. So I will be first creating a data provider where name equal to hybrid data. Then I am creating an object, right? I am reading the Excel file. I am creading the object called read Excel file keyword. This is the keyword, read Excel file. I am going to the sheet, right, where I can directly going to the test case sheet, similar way. And I am again, right, trying to go to the row number of count here. Okay, so last row minus the first row. So here I'll be not doing plus 1 because I am starting it with 0. So both the way I have tried to cover it. So in case you are not adding plus 1, so you can start with 0. Right? So that you will be starting with 0. Then for every row I am iterating it and I will be using another loop called for J loop, because for every row every column will be there and from that column I can get the value. I can convert it into some string, right? So that is the reasons I will be using some for loop, which is the inner for loop and outer for loop. So outer for loop will go for the row wise and the inner for loop will go for the column wise. And for every object I and j, I will be getting some row value and converting into string. So that is the part I have written in my data provider. Then now in the test cases itself, I will be using the same data provider, which is the nothing but hybrid test data. Same thing.
So is this new data provider you are creating? Means what is the meaning of this data provider?
Data provider I already covered in the testing. So this is the any name you can give it, because data provider it's concept where you can use the data driven framework. So because hybrid is nothing but the combination of data and framework. So data and keyword. So keyword definitely I'll be going through the keyword, but I'll be going as per the data also. So to reading the data I'll be using here two concept called row and column wise approach. So I need to collect the data from that particular column. So it will be for every I, it will be every j. because it is two dimensional array, right? Excel sheet is two dimensional array, so I'll be taking that one reference value. And here row count, I am taking it last row minus the first row, but I am starting with 0. That is the reason I am starting with 0. Okay, in case if you give plus 1, you can start with 1. And after that, same data provider, I am calling it here. And I am creating a method for test login. Here, I am giving the importance if condition. If my test case name not equal to null, and test case name dot length not equal to 0, then every time I am launching the browser, right? Means, in case there is a test case available, so that particular test case I am considering the test case, and for each and every test case I will be launching the browser and maximizing it, okay? And then other part I will be doing it similar way. I am creating the object for the read property file and property, same thing I am doing it. Keyword operation I am doing it, and I am doing the operation here. What is the operation? Keyword, object name, object type, and object value I am getting it. But here the value I am getting it with the help of data provider. So that is the approach, that is the only different approach. So reading and writing the data, right, from the data driven approach, and the keyword will be getting it from the Excel sheet. So if you run it, let's close that one. So you'll be finding some different approach here with the help of data driven or sorry hybrid framework. So it will launch the page, and again you will see another new browser will be opened, not in the same browser. So that one test case executed, other test case will be executed in the other browser, because that is the reason. For every test case we want to launch the browser, right? And if you want to quit it, you can quit it every time, and for the other test case it will open another browser. So that is a different type of permutation combination I have tried to give it, so that you can get to know the different way, right? So now it will opening another browser, because for every test case I want to launch another browser, because I want to give some differentiation, different flavor. That is the main objective. So it will give the username password and you click on the forgotten password link. So both my test case is working fine, and here both the browser I need to close it. I did not close it manually. Right now you can see the difference here. You can see every step is considered as a test case here, right? Instead of a unique one, every step is considered as a test case. So now you could see 10 test case. Okay, so now if you see here, go to the part, you can see first part is passed, right? This is my test case. Log into the ready page with invalid credential. So other parameter, it is blank. So what is the total number of parameter I am passing? I am passing one parameter, which is nothing but the test case. Second was the keyword. Third one is the object name. Fourth one is the object type. And fifth one is the value. So for the first test case, first is having the value. Second, third, fourth, fifth are blank. For the second one, so first one, because the test case column is blank, but navigate to one column is there. And fifth column is having a value. For the third one, I am setting the text. So first one is blank, setting the text, username, ID I am entering it. Right? Similar way, this is the one test case. So that is called 5 test case here. Each and every row will be considered as a test case. So that is the differentiation I can give in the hybrid framework. Similarly, for the second test case, you can see that's why it will be considered as a 5 test case. So each and every number of row will be considered as a test case for the hybrid framework. So that's why you can distinguish based on a requirement, do the needful, okay? But that is some sort of different broader view of the hybrid and the keyword driven framework. So you can customize your code for your relevant requirement. There is no hard and fast rule is available. But I have tried to give you some different flavor, so that is the reason. But for some other case, right, somebody don't want to create the every step as a test case. So that's fine. It's not be a problem. You can do it. Just you need to update your code accordingly. Okay, it might take some time to revisit your code, but you can do it. Okay, so that is the different part I have tried to cover it today. So definitely in the last session you already seen that how to read the data from the Excel, but today's session you can already see, right, how to read and write the data from the external source called Excel with the help of Apache PoI. And I have already created the keyword dependent framework and hybrid dependent framework. So whenever you will be creating the framework, first you need to create a project. Once that project is created, SRC file will be there automatically. You can add all your reference, right, which is the Apache PoI file, Selenium jar file, TestNG in your reference library. After that, you can create a properties file. You can create Excel where you can associate all your test cases, all your keyword, right, all your object name and value. After that, you can create multiple packages. So first you can create a object.properties file where you can add all your object, whatever URL is required, whatever element you will be interacting, what is the corresponding there element locator technique value. After that, you can first read the properties file and then you can click perform the different operation. Then you can try to read the Excel. Only you'll be reading the Excel till the sheet. So Excel path, Excel sheet name, and extension as well as the sheet name. After that, you can create your test cases. In case it is a keyword dependent framework, you can try to read it with the help of keyword. In case it is a hybrid framework, you will try to implement both the keyword and hybrid framework. And definitely, every test case will be considered as a test cases, right? So you need to implement the logic, because for your test cases, the remaining column will be blank. But whereas when the test case column is blank, the other operation column will be there, or the keyword column will be there. So that's why you can identify it and you can implement your code, and you can definitely deal with the keyword-driven and hybrid-driven framework. That's all for today's session. Thank you.